boss. Him on.
Thank you.
So this is actually part of the game. I'm controlling this. I thought we were actually done, but I can't turn around. Well, there were parts of that cinematic, I guess, that I was actually controlling. I didn't know if I needed to or not, but yeah, review of the game. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was super fun to just have a game that was focused on bosses. Each one had its uniqueness to it, and it made it really fun. I would take points off for the controls. The controls definitely need some work. I mean, if you compare it to the Uncharted games, the Uncharted 1 had terrible controls, and then they fixed it in 2, so it is doable. But when you're getting flung around, like right at the end when I was on his hand, it was getting flung around, I didn't know which way I needed to push in order to climb up, because I needed to get up on his arm, and then you don't really get a sense of distance neither. So the first time I made the jump from his arm to his like shoulder, I guess, his shoulder blade, I missed. I thought I was close enough, and I guess I wasn't. And yeah, but I mean, for an old game, it was super fun. Definitely 8 out of 10 for sure. It's a short game, but worth it. Worth every penny. I mean, even for a remake from a PS2 game to a PS3 game to a PS4 game. If this game releases on PS5, I will definitely be playing it, because I had a blast in this. And learning the enemies, it's one thing. I had watched a few speedruns a couple months back when I picked up the game, just because I wanted to get an idea as to what I was buying, and I just had a general idea of what I needed to do. But I mean, once you get going, it becomes pretty apparent as to what you have to do. But yeah, is this part of the credits? I'm not sure. But I guess she's stuck over there because she can't come this way, and the horse has a broken leg. The horse lives! That was nice to see.
Thank you.